Hello, advocates, and those of you that are not, my name is Mephisto, and it is my great pleasure to bring to you today Dark Souls 2. Alright. Sorry. Nursing a bit of a cold. Alright, everybody. So today we're going to be playing through Dark Souls 2 in preparation for Dark Souls 3. I'm going to be going over a bit of lore and a bit of the, like, kind of pertinent information. I'm not going to be putting up any Dark Souls 3.
Perhaps you've seen it. Maybe in a dream.
I don't have dreams.
A murky, forgotten land.
Oh god, it's raining out in the game and it's snowing out here. I live on the East Coast, by the way, and if you live on the East Coast too, be careful on your way into work or on your way home from work when you realize what's going on. Well, I look like crap.
A place where souls may mend your ailing mind.
I hope they can mend my ailing mind because I'm.
You will lose everything.
Well, that's not nice.
Once branded. The symbol of the curse.
You get a tattoo.
An augur of darkness.
Still sounds so weird. Augur?
Your past.
What's that?
Your future. Your very light.
Hey, baby, your face is melting.
None will have meaning, and you won't even care. By then, you'll be something other than human.
Pretty sure I will care if that happens.
A thing that feeds on souls.
What's that?
A hollow.
We're not in Bleach. There is no Ichigo here. There is a sword like Guts's, though.
Long ago, in a walled-off land far to the north, a great king built a great kingdom. I believe they called it Drang Lake. Perhaps you're familiar.
Nope.
No, how could you?
I don't know, how could I be?
But one day, you will stand before its decrepit gate.
Uh-huh.
Without really knowing why.
You might want to go to a dentist there. Oh well. What kind of time frame are we looking at here? Anyway. Sorry that I've been talking so much to the cutscene, guys. It's just like, I always get a little, what? That's a lot of bones. And that's a lot of fireflies on a tree. God, they've released the Nazgul. Oh! What are those things from Harry Potter? Not Death Eater. Dementors, that's it. They've released the Dementors.
Like a moth drawn to a flame. Your wings will burn in anguish.
Huh.
Time after time.
I'm standing before a giant swirling vortex. Doesn't seem to be the brightest move.
For that is your fate.
You just not do this and go home.
The fate of the cursed.
And you swan dived into it. Swan dove. This just screams bad idea. And again, I am a genius. I am a genius. Seriously though, guys, it really is starting to snow. If you do live on the East Coast, please use proper judgment when driving. Do not drive like a maniac because you will probably hit something or somebody. And we don't want that. Because you all are awesome people, and I don't want to hear about anybody going to jail because I accidentally hit somebody. Alright. I'm going to skip that part because it's not important. Welcome to the Things Betwixt, everybody. And that guy right there is not... And that guy right there... They're on playthrough... They're on at least playthrough one or two. I did New Game Plus... New Game Plus. I'm doing New Game for you all, so... Okay. We're just going to mosey right on through here. Woohoo! There's a bridge here. And yes, I know that there's another path over there, but we're not going to be going down that one right now. So, first things first, we're going to go talk to the old women here. And just so you know, guys, for this game, I'm going to be doing a bit of a hybrid.
What seems to be the ruckus?
Oh my, your face. The face of the curse.
Yes, I'm ugly, I'm sorry.
It's an undead. An undead has come to play.
They all end up here. All the ones like you.
You spoke to that kind old dear, didn't you?
I think.
You're finished. You'll go hollow.
Isn't that nice?
Yes. You'll become one of them. Hollows prey upon men. Feast upon their souls. This is the fate of the cursed.
I defy fate. I am Batman.
What is your name?
For this, we're going to go with a name that for some reason I always tend to use for this. I always use either Marcus or Isaac. Don't know why.
At least you know your own name.
I do indeed, thank you.
Here's your reward for sharing.
Do I get something?
It's a human effigy.
Okay.
Take a closer look.
I'm looking pretty closely.
Who do you think it's supposed to be?
I don't know anybody that looks like that.
Think back. Deep into your past.
Looks like a potato. Or a peanut.
Yes. It's an effigy of you.
I am not that fat, lady. I am not that fat at all. I take great offense to this. Let's see. Cleric, no. Sorcerer, explored, deprived. Life-affirming flesh. Ooh, this is actually a really tough choice. We're gonna be a cleric.
I was on my way to do something. How in the world did I end up here?
Took away some of the best ones.
I don't know.
A life ring! I'm honestly not gonna mess with the rest of... No, wait. We do have to change one thing. Nope.
My hair.
Nope. There we go! We have to be as prissy looking as possible. Prom and Percy looking as possible! I hate colds. Sorry, buddy!
Wait, we need a tattoo. We have to look cool. That way all the chicks in this place are gonna dig us.
I don't actually know. Just say no, I don't have any tattoos, so...
Homeland?
What does that have to do with anything? Okay, there we go. Yes, we will be from whatever homeland that is. No, we are not doing that. There we go. That's been...
All people come here for the same
What's that?
Reason. To break
Cool.
The curse. You're no different, I should think.
I don't know. Am I?
Doesn't stand a chance. You never know.
You all are kind of rude, and that candle has a very weird animation. The fire doesn't really have much of a better, but the candle has a really weird animation.
Through the door and trot along to the key.
Okay, I will do so.
But remember, hold on to your souls.
All right.
They're all that keep you from going hollow. Oh, I'll fool you no longer. You'll lose your souls. All of them. Over and over again.
Oh, throw the controller! I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to throw the controller. Well, if I'm gonna lose my souls over and over again, what the heck's the point? Okay, I'm gonna set this up the way I... Aww. Okay, so apparently my guy cannot hold things right. Alright, here we go! We're out of that house, which took for freaking ever. Seriously, it has been 11 minutes at the end of the... It has been 11 minutes into this video. Do I not have the torch? Does I not have torch? Nope, apparently I does not have torch. Okay. So I'm going up here. I know that there's a treasure chest in here. Yes. Woo! Oh, just a UNFG. That's worthless. That is worthless, I say. Okay, now. If y'all don't know, open this fog gate. Dark Souls 3 is slated to come out in a few more. Slated to come out in a few months, I believe in April, on April 12th. I think that's when it comes out. I could be, you know, I could be making it all up or completely forgetting something, but I believe it's coming out on April the 12th. And we're not going down there. Back attack! Smack you in the ground. And so since it is coming out on April the 12th, and since I played Dark Souls 2 for another channel back when I was kind of just screwing around with this whole thing. Oh god, you live. I played Dark Souls 2 back when I was screwing around with this whole, like, channel thing. And I did some videos of it, and they weren't really good. So, with my setup being a little better, I thought that I'd go ahead and make some videos of it. Ouch, you shot me in the back. You never shoot a man in the back. Unless he is trying to stab you. And they're all wearing the same clothes that I am. I didn't even notice that until just now. Or that I was. Didn't even notice that until just now. What am I wearing right now? Archdrake robes. Whoops! Robes of the Archdrake sect of Lindelt. Little is known about the Archdrake sect. To indulge sect keepers of Lindelt's histories, including the only record of its foundation. The tome they have good reason to keep hidden away. So I'm going to guess that Lindelt was kind of a bad place. This is actually armor that I believe... This is actually armor that an enemy later in the game, the Archdrakes, have. Oh, I don't know if that's worked. One down. Whee! Touch. Okay. We can't go through there because there's a statue blocking us. We need a special item. We'll have to come back later. I just now noticed I'm not wearing shoes. Okay, so this is going to be kind of a, the White Knight kind of build. Sorry, I'm looking up there because I'm used to my camera being up there. My plan is supposed to be a White Knight kind of build. see all these messages. They're left by other players because we're actually... Praise the sun! Do I have that? No, I don't. New character. Good luck. Gorgeous view ahead. Hurrah for front. And there we go. Drop down there. Do I drop down there? Nope. Don't drop down. Drop down here. There we go. Drop down onto this thing. We're gonna grab that. And we get the same stuff that we just started off with. And binoculars. I've played this part way too many times, folks. Okay, so this is Majula. This is our kind of hub area. If you played Dark Souls or 1, if you played Dark Souls 1 or Demon Souls and haven't played this one, then this is your Nexus in reference to Dark Souls or to Demon Souls, and your Firelink Shrine in reference to Dark Souls 1. This guy needs a key that we're gonna get in the level coming up. It's down that way. I think this guy over here I can buy armor from. Yeah, this is Malin. This guy.
Well,
he sells armor.
I came from the west.
You came from Vol.
Have you been there? Very competitive. But I don't even know what. Everything's a group calling themselves the Blue Sentinels. You can't even run. They claim to be working. Well, I.
Don't worry, Marlin. You'll be seeing me again, and you all probably won't be seeing when I come back here to deal with him, because I'm going to pick up some more items. But in this chest, we receive a Titanite shard, something that we can use to upgrade weapons. Going down. I'm not going to be making it to the first boss today, folks. So if that's what you're here for, I'm sorry. I'm not going to be able to do that today. I'm only going to be doing this for about 30-ish minutes. Oh yeah, now, I'm going to talk about him here in a minute, but here is a very mysterious character.
Oh, undead are we? And one without much time remaining. Just about ready to fall apart, I'd say. Not exactly the time to be chatting with a cat. Well, suit yourself. Oh yes.
Yeah, this is Shalquar.
Call me Shalquar. Enchanté. So, what did you want anyway?
Thank you, Shalquar, for being weird.
Isn't it all? This place is.
Okay.
Are you going to see?
There we go, here's the one.
Those four who have grown so incredibly ancient. They must have sprouted quite a thick coat of moss by now. For heaven's sake. No one even knows their names anymore. Imagine that. Yes. Were you?
Thank you.
Nothing. Well, that's just.
Okay, now I'm gonna shut. No, don't do that. Shut the doors you're leaving. It's rude to leave someone's door open when they have one. Poor Malin doesn't have a door. Okay, so. Give me just a second to talk to the Herald person, Majigger, over here. We'll be coming back to talk to him later. That guy sitting over there, we're gonna talk to him. Oh, wait, I already lit that, okay. That's when you rest at a bonfire that will restore your health and the little Gatorade drink I'm about to get from her.
Are you the next
one? I don't know.
Or merely a pawn of.
I don't know, but I look damn good.
Bearer of the curse.
Yes.
I will remain by your side till this frail hope shatters. Take this with you. Go on and see Heat King.
Yay! Now I can level up.
There's once so that.
Oh yeah, there we go. Yeah, now let me go talk to this guy up here, the last person that's here. And then we'll start getting into things. This guy's name is Salden. He is your crestfallen blue phantom. Or your crestfallen blue whatever the heck it is.
Come on.
Do
you when protect?
Sure, we'll start off with that one. Because it gives us a ring with a little bit more health.
That is a people.
People are really good. Okay, yeah, I forgot that I had the life ring. Okay. With that done, Now we're going to go into the Forest of Giants. At least we're going to start heading in there. We won't make it super duper far, but we'll get in there. You're going to see little messages like this. That's from people online. You're going to see these little blood stains. That's where people online have died. I believe in like New Game Plus Plus, this becomes a mimic. But anyway, yes, let's talk about some of the interesting things here. Okay, so Shalquar. Shalquar, we'll start off with her stuff. Shalquar talked about the old ones. Ancient beings that have lived so long that people have forgotten their names. They are the four kind of big kind of bosses in this game. Like, there are tons of bosses throughout the game, but they are the four biggest ones. They have the most powerful souls. And so they are the ones that you have to... They're kind of like, they're the ones to beat. I think once you've beaten all four of them, you can get to the Shrine of Amana and go see the king. Okay, so... that. Jump! And we make it. Good. We got the Homeward Bone and the Soul of the Lost Undead. Those are the four big enemies to beat. And they're the most powerful and arguably the most difficult of the bosses. I mean, some of them are. I think the one I had the most trouble with was the Duke's Deer Phrygia, which is a giant spider, because that dude's a weirdo. But yeah, you have those four old ones that Shalquar was talking about. Then, of course, you have a ton of other little bosses. Looks like this campfire over here. This bonfire over here. I'm not even sure what this is supposed to be. But yeah, you have the four great old ones that Shalquar was talking about. And they're the ones that, in every single cycle, someone beats in order to become the next king of the land. That's the thing. In order to become the next king of... right now, known as Runway, you beat the four great ones. And every kingdom lasts for so long, and then something happens. You gotta love wacky physics, don't you? And then something happens, and the kingdom gets kind of reset. Ow. Die. Could've used your shield. Wait a minute. Oh no. Like, I know that the swords that they use are not all that powerful, but I do like the design. And you'll see what I mean later on when I do eventually get one. Or if I don't, I guess you won't, so. Look forward to it or don't, at your own leisure. And now there, I believe there's supposed to be a guy that, nope. See, item ahead, beware of enemy. Yeah, you go to pick up that item, then that axe dude comes down and starts chopping off your balls. You mean your testicles. Okay. Ooh, not going up the ladder.
Thank you, sir.
All right. So, this was once an enormous fortress. And to be perfectly honest, it still kind of is pretty darn big, but... after Vendrit, now... After... Can you hit... Can you hit him? Please? Thank you. Okay. So, after Vendrit, the guy who was king of this land, became king, he went across the sea and took something important from the giants. Well... as you can imagine, the giants didn't like that too much. And so they invaded. They crossed the sea and they attacked Drung Lake, which was the beginning of the end for this great country. And so that's why this place looks like it does. Because literally, this place has been pretty much destroyed. Now, I don't know if the giants themselves are immune to the curse of the undead. I doubt it, as nothing here ever really nothing here ever really seems to be. But when you run into them, they're not undead. And a lot of the soldiers aren't undead, so it kind of gives you the idea that becoming undead is something that happened, I suppose not recently, but it's something that didn't happen too long ago for this kingdom. Okay, so we're picking up tons of little items. All of them useful in their own ways. So, okay. That's cool. Whoa. Hello, buddy. Now, as you saw... One second, folks. Alright! Sorry about that, guys. I had a call that I had to take. I was expecting a call today, but I didn't expect it was going to come this soon. So, there was a big battle here, and that's why this place kind of looks broken down and crap.
Ow.
Against the giants that cross the sea. Now, everyone's been kind of a lot of people that love the theory around this game have been speculating on what that actually is. Why did the giants cross the sea to attack Lordran? Really? I don't even have enough. Oh my god, I need more dexterity. No, I don't want that. I know. Now, a lot of people have been speculating on what exactly it was that he stole from the giants, and why exactly it was so important that it made the giants come across the sea. Well, some people have theorized that the giants are actually the characters from Lord Gwyn, who was the big Lord of Sunlight from the first one, or if not him exactly, then some of his relatives. Others have theorized that it was just something very important. No, stop that. I did not know I had left you all alive. Ah, darn, that was a shield. Others have speculated that it was the Lord Vessel, as you can find, which is the thing from the first game that unlocked the ability to fast travel for you. And the main reason that a lot of people think that is because you can actually find that thing. You can actually find one of those broken in the big manor that's there in the jeweler. I myself don't personally agree with that little train of thought. I don't think that the giants were the original lords from Lordran. Because I'm pretty sure that this place is actually built on what had once been Lordran. And that when you destroyed Lord Gwyn and them, that was basically the end. They were done. Like they could not come back when you killed them. But an important thing to note is that in the Dark Souls series, Dark Souls specifically, no, not Demon Souls. In Dark Souls specifically, in Dark Souls, whoa, buddy there, calm down. Whenever this is beginning to happen, like whenever the curse is starting to return and the fire needs relit. Ow. You shot me in the butt. There's always something that comes with it, in this case specifically, the curse. There's always a curse that comes with it. Because, you know, it can't just be that things are going bad. It can't just be that things are going south. There's always a curse that goes with it, and that's what spurs you, the protagonist, to go and stop it. Venture forth bravely and stop this curse. And the reason for that is because they give you some kind of external stimulation so that you actually want to go do it. And here is Merchant Hag Melincha. A lot of people call her a hag, but I kind of like her. She's cool. I'm gonna buy a cestus.
Thank you.
Because the cestus doesn't take as much to equip. Really? I don't know what I'm talking about. Lord. I don't even have enough to equip a friggin' dagger. I'm gonna run around with a broken straight sword. Okay.